Bobby, as your lawyer, I could not accept that you're only getting 33.82% off the profits of Paper Jew. So, I renegotiated you up to 41.67%.
Wow, 41.67?
41.678. Tracy, make 5 copies of the new Paper Jew deal.
Right away.
Hey, you know, Tracy and my friend Shrug are quite an item these days.
Intercourse?
Imminent.
That's fine, as long as she stays focused at work.
Boy, you are so headstrong.
Headstrong. I'm headstrong. What about you?
No, I'm not headstrong. If anything, I'm head weak.
Trust me, you're headstrong. You know, Robbie, the fact is we're both so headstrong. If we ever dated, we would jump in the sack, have spectacular, unrestrained, gymnastic, berserk sex for a week. Then we'd hate each other.
Maybe we could just date for 5 days.
You got a deal. I'll drop the contracts.
Don't you still get residuals from Dirty Dancing?
Please. The last check I got was for $3.18 because some fat, drunken businessman ordered it in a hotel in Miami.
How do you know that?
Actually, I ordered it. He was asleep.
Hey, you know what my girlfriend thought of Dirty Dancing?
No, what?
Actually, I have no idea. I just like working the phrase "my girlfriend" into sentences.
So, how's it going?
With my girlfriend? Great. Except, yeah, I do have one sex question.
Oh, here we go.
When you're done, you know, all done.
I'm with you.
What's the etiquette on how long the guy should wait before disengaging?
Okay. The rule of thumb is you should stay put the length of an average John Denver song.
Good rule of thumb. Because, you know, I have a girlfriend now.
Could you ask Robbie these sex questions?
Oh, no. These are the nuts and bolts things. Robbie's such a romantic.
We're gonna have 5 days of pure, wicked, squalid sex, and that's it. Bing, bang, boom, end of relationship.
Robbie's a free spirit. He doesn't really operate within the system.
We're operating within the legal system. We're gonna have a contract drawn up stipulating that the relationship is to last 5 days, and that's it.
This is the sickest thing I've ever heard. It's like a typical Los Angeles relationship, except this one's sanctioned by the California State Bar Association.
I just can't take the mystery of relationships anymore. I finally have one relationship where there's no potential for pain. It's all pre-planned. I know when it starts, I have clauses guaranteeing my rate of intercourse, and it ends with none of the tears, none of the guilt.
What if you end up liking her?
Well, now that's when it gets ugly. I gotta go.
Okay, fusilli shrimp, thank you. Okay. And Nicoise salad.
Niswa.
My mistake.
Oh, no.
God, I love shrimp. I'm insane about shrimp.
I'm allergic to all shellfish.
Yeah. It's overrated.
I can die from any shellfish, even secondhand shellfish.
Secondhand shellfish kills?
Oh, yeah. Once I almost died because my mom ate shrimp and then kissed me. What is it that guy is eating over there?
Calamari.
Oh, is it good?
Nah.
No, really?
It's delicious.
It's squid, right?
Yeah, squid.
Squid's not shellfish.
No.
I think I'm gonna try some calamari.
Whoa, wait. Now, squid is not shellfish, but it's like shellfish. Squids idolize shellfish.
Well, look, Artie, if I'm allergic to calamari, you got 15 minutes to get me to the hospital before my throat closes.
Oh, my God.
And Cedar Sinai Hospital is 6 blocks away.
Oh, my God.
Okay, if you notice my lips turning inside out or my eyes swelling shut, that would indicate it's a good time to pay the check and carry me to the car.
Oh, my God.
Ernie, I want one order of calamari, please.
Sure. Oh, and FYI, Nicoise Niswas, same thing.
We're negotiating the whole deal later today.
Oh, you need to get a lawyer.
Well, Maggie can't negotiate it for me.
Conflict of interest.
Yes.
I could be your lawyer.
You?
Oh, yeah, I've played lawyers in several straight-to-video movies. One even shot here in these United States.
Guam is not a state.
They vote.
Yeah, but...
Robbie, I don't need to go to some McDonald's law school to negotiate your deal. I know the law. I've slept with you, so I know what you want. Delicious.
Great. Okay, let's go to the hospital.
I'm fine.
No, you might be dying. I think you're dying. Oh, my God. Medic!
Just kidding.
So, as you can see in subsection C, you, Robbie, here and after referred to as Honey Pie, must pay me a genuine compliment upon greeting me and again upon leaving.
In return for which you, Maggie, here and after referred to as Maggie, agree not to try and dress my client.
Moving on. At the expiration of said relationship, the parties may not explicitly or implicitly engage in actions intended to cause guilt, sadness, remorse, open parentheses, feelings, close parentheses. Now, sign here. Initial here. Here. Here.
Great. See you tonight for sex. Oh, yeah, great suit. Oh, yeah.
Oh, Shrug, that was wonderful.
Well, life on the farm is kind of laid back. Ain't much an old country boy like me can't hack. It's early to rise, early in the sack. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Oh, Robbie, that was amazingly headstrong sex.
Yeah. I'll be right back.
You should have seen Lauren's eyes light up when she tasted calamari. It was like a kid trying chocolate for the first time.
I find chocolate very binding.
Huh. The thing is I've never had any means to attract Lauren with. Youth, exuberance, verve, optimism, these are just clubs not in my bag. Age, experience, and squid, that's all I got.
How long do you think you can play the squid card?
Oh, at least for 2 weeks. You got fried calamari. Maybe just a week. Jen?
Hey.
You the man.
What?
I used your rule of thumb. Perfect thumb. At the close of business, I turn to John Denver. He sings, I stay put. The song ends, and I gently excused myself.
Glad I could help.
Oh, you don't even know what we're talking about.
The John Denver rule. I know the John Denver rule. I just stopped using it after he died.
How respectful of you.
Actually, I haven't had occasion to use it.
You haven't touched your food.
Paging Mr. Amari. Mr. Cal Amari.
Sick of calamari.
Already? Just one day? Supposed to take a week.
I had it for dinner last night and again this morning. Calamari.
Squid pro quo, huh?
What?
Man, nothing.
You got me hooked on calamari and now I'm needing something stronger. I need shellfish. I've got to put money in the meter.
A tough break. She's a good kid.
Yeah.
Maybe I can help.
How?
The crab legs on the menu, they're not crab legs.
What are you talking about?
It's mock crab. It's actually made from scrod that's been shaped into crab legs, but you didn't hear it from me.
I don't follow you.
Wait. Order her crab legs and convince her to eat them. She'll try them, not get sick. You're a hero.
That's not bad.
Well.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
Is there something else?
Well, I thought for helping you out, you'd give me some money.
Oh. We got a problem. Maggie was pouting last night.
Wait, pouting's not allowed under the terms of the contract. What happened?
I don't know. We had berserk sex. We finished. I went to the bathroom. I came out. She was pouting.
Wait. You finished and immediately disengaged?
Yeah.
Does the name John Denver mean anything to you?
Crab?
Crab. Crab salad.
Artie?
Yeah?
Are you trying to kill me?
No, 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 Lauren. I just wanted you to experience crab just like you experienced calamari.
But calamari is not shellfish. Crab is shellfish. I've heard the expression crab shell. That's where they get it from.
Look, what are you so scared of? You'll eat the crab, your lips will turn inside out, your eyes will slam shut. I'll pay the check, grab you, rush you to the hospital. We're 6 blocks from Cedar Sinai. I'll have you there 8-10 whole minutes before you die.
Okay, here are the crabs. Real crabs. 100% crabs.
Hey, thank you, Ernie.
Those are crabs.
I owe you an apology. I think I might have been a bit hasty on the retreat the other night.
It was bad form.
Nonetheless, you had no grounds on which to pout. My client breached no part of our agreement. However, as a measure of good faith, we are prepared to add a clause stating how long he must stay put.
How long did you have in mind?
I don't know about the length of a John Denver song. Perhaps Sunshine on My Shoulder.
No deal. Beatles, Hey Jude.
Give me a break. I'm only human. No one even knows when that song ends.
Hey Jude it is.
See you tonight.
Nice blouse.
Hey, all. I just stopped by to say hello. Tracy and I are going for a little picnic for lunch today. Oh, boy, did we have a lovely evening last night. Transcendentally sweet lovemaking. Peaceful pillow talk. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Well, life on the farm's kind of laid back. Ain't much an old country boy like me can't hack.
Shrug, let's not listen to music tonight. I just want to lie here in the dark with you. Shrug.
She wouldn't let me whistle. I had to sing the song to myself.
Uh-huh. So what's the problem?
I left out a verse.
Oh, so you caught an earlier train.
Yes.
Oh, you better rectify that right away, country boy. Don't let it fester.
I will not let it fester. I'm going to make it up to her tonight. So do you know any really long songs?
Women seem to like Hey Jude.
I'm back for more crab meat.
Have you had the crab meat here?
Yeah, Artie got me to try it.
Arthur.
Uh-huh.
I don't like the crab meat here. It doesn't taste like crab.
Does it?
I never tried it.
That guy over there is having some.
Excuse me, might I sample a tad of your crab?
No.
Stop being such a baby.
Order your own.
Why? If you give me some of yours, then together we can save a crab.
I'm a member of Save the Crabs.
It looks like crab meat. Feels like crab meat. That's not crab. Ernie, what is this?
Oh, no, that's crab. That is good crab. That is damn good crab.
Ernie!
It's the old rolled up fish to look like crab meat trick.
Damn you!
She has no idea it was fake crab.
The old rolled up fish to look like crab meat trick.
I'm telling you, Robbie, she was ecstatic. I'm widening her horizons. I'm becoming an integral part of her life.
That fake crab is a sordid business.
So how's it going with Maggie?
Oh, the whole relationship is tied up in litigation. There's a lot of anger between us, but we're legally forbidden to express it. Next time, I'm getting a no speaking clause.
You began to sound like my Uncle Bernie. Man's a misogynist pig. He hates when women even talk. He said the perfect woman would be named Muta.
Okay, I think this is all settled. According to the new terms of Section 53, paragraph 9, for the remainder of the 5-day period, Honey Pie and Maggie are strictly forbidden to express any and all suggestions of emotion. Agreed?
Fine.
Yeah.
Great boots.
I don't wear boots.
Oh. Hey, Tracy and I worked things out.
That's great, Shrug.
Yeah, we had a little disagreement, but we talked it out amongst ourselves. It was really very emotional. Chock full of emotion. Hey,
But what is life without emotions? It's death. Stone cold death. Am I right?
Shruggles.
Oh, yeah.
Wait. You want to try lobster?
Why not? I had the crab. Apparently, I'm not allergic to shellfish anymore.
Yeah, crab is one thing, but lobster is a much more, you know, death-inducing shellfish. It has a much higher content of hypopolyallergy-citic acid. Like 5 milligrams per claw.
Wow. So.
I guess I'll have to settle for fish molded into the shape of lobster.
So how'd you find out?
Ernie.
Ah, Ernie. He is quite a jerk.
Arthur, what were you thinking? What if I went to another restaurant and ordered crab today?
I guess we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Look, I just wanted you to experience shellfish.
But that wasn't even really shellfish.
Yeah, that's where the whole thing kind of falls apart.
You must have had some other motive for this.
Come on, like what?
No, look, I just wanted to open you up to new experiences. I mean, you're from the Midwest, you're young, it's not like you've had a life.
What?
That didn't come out right.
Arthur, I have had a life. I moved out here alone with nothing. I got jobs, I got a place to live. I've been flown around the country for massages. I've served subpoenas and been shot at. I started surfing, taking classes, started dating guys over the age of 20. And then what else? I'm getting my eyelashes tinted tomorrow. Oh my God, it's gonna be so cool. You don't have to worry about mascara or anything. What was I? My life. I have had a life. I mean, what have you done that I am missing so much?
Other than eating shellfish?
Look, Arthur, I appreciate the thought, but shellfish is not gonna be a part of my life. I've accepted it.
Well, I have not accepted it.
Oh, Robbie's gone?
He's napping.
Oh, lucky man. Tracy and I just had a wonderful nap. You know, you ought to try napping with your lover.
What?
You know, if you take naps, you don't get bags under your eyes.
I have bags?
Oh, no bags.
No, you're lying. You're saying I have bags.
Well, not bags.
Then what?
Valises?
That was some documentary. Vietnam, what a tragedy.
I found the whole thing a tet offensive.
Okay, let's go to my place. We'll take a quick nap and then we can get down to business.
A nap? That is not in the contract.
You just took a nap?
I took a nap on my own time. You can't take a nap on our sex time.
Oh, that's it. I can't take this anymore. I want to take the whole relationship to arbitration.
The relationship ends in 26 hours. Where are you going to find an arbitrator on such short notice?
Hey, now there you are, Jennifer. You left your sunglasses at the restaurant.
Thanks.
Sure.
Hey, are you a fair-minded individual?
Oh, I like to think so.
Good, because we need you to arbitrate a dispute.
Oh, no buts.
You're doing it.
Waiters and sunglasses, you get nothing but trouble.
See how napping can be construed as emotion.
Yeah, gotta go along with that.
Napping with one's lover is very intimate, hence emotional.
Gotta go along with that.
He is not my lover. This relationship is purely sex.
Gotta go along with that.
Nice arbitrating.
Thanks. Perhaps while one of the parties naps, the other party can watch TV, thereby eliminating all intimacy.
That's not bad.
No, it's not bad at all.
It's still napping on my sex time.
Robbie, I strongly advise you to accept the arbitrator's compromise.
No, I won't accept it.
Robbie.
No, and that's final.
You know what? I've had it.
What?
I am dropping you as a client.
You're not even a lawyer.
She's not?
She's an actress.
You're Jennifer Grey, the actress?
Maybe.
You play a good lawyer.
So do you.
Robbie, I know I said it would take us a week to hate each other, but I kind of hate you now.
Yeah, me too. Let's just end it now.
Sorry.
Yeah.
You can go. I said you can go?
Yeah, I thought for doing the arbitration, you could give me some money.
Okay, dig in. Now, as soon as you start feeling your throat close, give Dr. DeBakey a look, and he'll give you an injection. If that doesn't work, we have an ambulance outside.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Mm, that was incredible. I've never tasted anything like this. Okay, I'll take that shot now.
Oh, Shrug, that was great.
Oh, yeah. I'm really glad we worked out our problems.
Yeah, I think we came up with the perfect solution.
It's fail-safe.
Okay, you start.
One Mississippi.
Two Mississippi.
Three Mississippi.
Four Mississippi.
Five Mississippi.